How did Jesus know who he was? Well, not just the way he was treated as being special by his family, but he also contained the seven spirits of God. The fullness of God was within him. He walked the earth with the same spirit that created the earth. He had the power. And even though he had it, he didn't use it. Even the disciples wanted him to call fire down from heaven. He didn't use it. God's purpose and plan was to show his creation how much he loved them and how rebellion leads to what we have today, disaster. Granted, there was wars, but war is part of free will. Part of man's fallen nature is to gain territory, and that was basically the spiritual problem in heaven. They wanted to rule in heaven. They wanted to set up their kingdoms and their governments. And problem is, when you want to do that, then you have to, you know, you have to have people subjects. Every time you set up a kingdom, you have to have a group of subjects. You know, I mean, it's just not. So there's always this fighting over territory. The angels wanted that in heaven. They wanted to have set up their systems of government. They didn't want to worship the sun. They wanted to have their own orders, and they didn't want to do what God had requested of them, and that was to come and worship the sun simply when God called for it, when God said, come worship the sun. It was just a given. Today we have one day a week that we're to celebrate Christ, we're to celebrate in church what Jesus did for us. And come to learn of the word and come knowledge of the word. And so we go to church so that we can learn and grow in Christ, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together as we see the day approaching. But this particular symbol is from the house of Babel. It was probably the third or fourth one that I did. And kind of a thing with the Lord and I, and my relationship with God goes back to me calling out to him when I was 18 years old, May 1978, never forget it. He appeared to me. He seen the light. He spoke to me. He spoke to me the night before, told me I was going the wrong way, said five little words to me, you're going the wrong way, said them twice as I turned around to head back on the other way, going on Millville Street in New Hampshire. I turned around, I head back, and I seen five vintage cars go by me, and each one of the cars was somebody I knew who headed the wrong way. It kind of frightened me. It kind of shook me up. I went home. I cried out to him. The next morning, my entire room was immaculate white. But no one ever remembered my birthday in my family. No one ever, my father, my mother. It was a rare thing. These were my step-parents. My father was a carpenter. My stepfather was a carpenter. My mother's name was Lucille. She acted as my covering. I was 23 when I gave my life finally to Christ. It was May of 1982 when I finally surrendered to Christ. 5 years after the visitation, I finally surrendered and gave my life completely to him, May of 1982. And the number five has followed me throughout my life. But this particular crop circle reveals the birth date, my birth date, believe it or not. It's just uncanny. When I saw it, I knew what he was saying to me. He was began speaking to me that it was his blessing to me. It was his gift to me for lifting his son up out of the dirt, for showing the angels where his son belongs, that his son doesn't belong in the dirt. He belongs high and lifted up. Jesus says, if I be lifted up, I shall draw all men unto me. What's he referring to? Well, he takes us all the way to America to show us this insult that his enemy had made of him, done to him in front of the angels. And God was waiting for one man to come along and recognize this attack on his son's honor. The devil built the symbols of the battle of good and evil. God only had to name his the Lion of the Tribe of Judah. And so these are the symbols of the battle. And he had to wait for enough men to be in the area in the world in order to cover it up. Lucifer was the covering cherub, but he was not the light. He was the light bearer, but he was not the light. He was the covering cherub. He was created to cover and protect. The covering is to protect. That's what a covering does. He was created the last of his angels, God's angels. And we learn that from the story of Joseph and Jacob. A coat of many colors is not given to the brothers, it's given to Joseph. And Joseph's the son of whom he loves, who he works the hardest for. Then we have Benjamin, who is Joseph's brother, who you don't find out what's going on in the story until Benjamin reveals himself to you and comes into Egypt. Then you understand what the devil meant for evil, God meant for good. So this symbol here, this incorporates this birth date of mine, because left of it would be the center, the three major circles, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, the Son in the center, protected by the number 6 and the number 9. If you were to write these out as numbers, 619 would be its equivalent. But to the left of the 6, to the left is subtraction, to the right is addition. Subtract 6 from 1, it's 5. You got 5, 9, that's the year born, birth. 1 plus 9 is 10, day born. So it's 6-10-59 is my birth date. And if you were to add those numbers up, 59 plus 10 is 69, plus the 6 is 75, divided by 5 gives you 555 five times, right? 555. 555 always comes before judgment. You know, mercy always comes before judgment, 555. So how did Jesus know that he was the Son of God? Because he had the fullness. He had the lamps of God dwelling within him. When I found what the enemy was hidden in Egypt, and God showed me this, he began to impart to me the same lamps that Lucifer once carried in heaven to do the same thing that Lucifer did in heaven here on the earth. Only, I'm totally unprepared for this. I mean, this was just a big surprise to me. I did not expect this at all. I knew that God and I had an intimate relationship, but I didn't know how intimate that relationship was until this shows up. Until these circles show up, and then they all point to these Bible passages. God's opening his word up for the world so that the world can come and fight the enemy, fight this invisible force by God presenting the word to the world. Only the wicked would try to keep the word of God away from the masses. Only the wicked, the evilest among you, would hold the word from your heart, would hold God's laws and commandments from your heart. Only the wickedest among you would keep the word of God from you. Because it's the word that fights the enemy. It's the word that destroys the enemy. And evil, wicked men would keep this word from you and create the society that you have today and then come in and say, we want to control it. Those are wicked, evil people who keep the word of God from among you. So God has used England to open up his word so that you could see his word and you could fight the enemy. But in this particular one, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, 6 is the number of man, 9 is the number of judgment. God is showing how precious his Son is, that we will never not worship the Son in heaven. It will always be, we will understand why it is necessary to worship the Son. In heaven, the angels began to doubt. They began to doubt and question the existence and viability of the Son. Seeing is believing. Can't see it, can't believe in it. We know that John says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. We serve one God who reveals himself in three persons, both Father, Son, Holy Spirit. We know this. If you take the Star of David reveals the Trinity in there. The Trinity is hidden within the Star of David. It's right there. You just have to look very closely for it. You'll find him. But this symbol, you take the 6, 1, and 9, and you add that up, you come up with the number 16. We'll put 16 off to the side for a second here. Then you take the circles that are in the center. There is 14, outside the center, there are 14 smaller circles, and there are two raised numbers there. So you take the 2 times the 14, and you multiply 2 times 14, which gives you 28. You add that to 16, and you come up with the number 44. Well, 4 plus 4 is 8. 8 is the number of perfection. When God created man and created this plane, this existence, this earth, he actually separated perfection. He was actually dividing perfection. Heaven was a perfect place, but now rebellion had come in, and now he's separating perfection. 4 plus 4 is 8 is the number for perfection. 8 is a number when you lay it on its side, it's infinity. If you split it down in the middle and you turn one on its other, turn one on the other, It's 33. That's the age that Jesus died at the cross. But perfection is the number 8. In 4:4, you go back to Genesis 4:4, and you'll see this is where God has respect for Abel and his offering. God has respect for Abel and his offering. See, Abel had figured out what God wanted at the beginning. Abel knew what God wanted at the beginning. Without being told, he figured it out. He knew that sacrifice covers shame. He knew that his parents had been in shame, and God went and sacrificed some animals to cover their shame. And he learned from seeing, by observation, he learned, I observed and I learned what God was looking for. What was he looking for at the end of the days? Because my God is a God of love, great compassion, great mercy. I wish you knew my God. He loves you and has great compassion and great mercy for the world. He sends mercy in before he sends judgment. There's always a warning. There's always a prophet that rises up and warns the world of impending judgment. Noah, Jonah, Elijah. People like this come and warn of judgment unless there's repentance. Jonah, for instance. And so judgment never falls before you have some sort of warning. So God raises up one man out of the earth, just like he did in heaven. He took one creature, and he made him, he was the last of God's angels, Lucifer, the light bearer. He was not the light. He was made as a covering cherub. Now, if you go to Jacob and Joseph, you see the story there. Joseph gets the coat of many colors. The brothers don't see that coat until Joseph comes into the picture. So the coat comes closer to the fact that the son is going to be presented to the creation. The angels have been asking, let's see the sun. If you can't believe it, if you can't see it, you can't believe it. They had fallen away. Free will had taken its course, had gone south. If you can't see it, you can't believe it. So what did God have to do? God had to make man to reveal the sun to the angels. We worship one God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. So in John, it says, when God, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Yes, Jesus was there. He was the heart of the Father. He was in the heart of the Father. Without the Son, God would not have created. But now they were asking to see the sun. They were not knowing what God, well, they were asking God to do. See, if they knew what they were asking God to do, you think they would have not rebelled? You know, visualization, learning, education. God is a great visual master. He teaches through visuals. We learn by doing visuals. And so these visuals that God has put out there in England is his word opened up to the world to help fight. It means Jesus is on his way. Jesus is coming back. And we must prepare the way for the bride. And there must be someone must prepare the way. So God takes one man out of the earth and gives to him the same thing that he had given Lucifer in heaven, the lamps, the very lamps that made these crop circles. So God gives him the lamps. See, Abel had his life cut short because the enemy thought he was the one who was going to crush his head. Well, God doesn't want to make him a complete fool. I mean, he wants to give him at least one right thing, right? But Abel couldn't crush the head of the serpent without the blood of Christ. So the blood of Christ is important to come in and crush the head of the serpent. And who's the head of the serpent? Well, I take you all the way. We take you all the way to America to show you who's the head of the serpent. Who's the liar? Who's the deceiver? Who's really the Antichrist here? Who's trying to build a Nazi-like world empire? Who's trying to do the same thing that they did 60 years ago right here in America and destroy our country? See, God is showing you and revealing. So what is he trying to do? He's trying to set everybody who's caught in this demonic religious system free. And as the outpouring of the great falling away takes place from this religious, demonic, devilish system, many will fall into the church in these last days. We'll have this great harvest. The kingdom of Satan starts to fall down like a house of cards. Have a good day, and God bless you.